definitely some strange sounds coming from this side of the room.
I see the trap door. Interact with trap door. Oh, there we go.
Shit. That did not sound good.
Let's get closer. Whoa. Oh, shit. The stairs broke.
Oh, that's just swell.
Okay. You should be able to get up that, no problem. There's rock right beneath the stairs there.
He's dead. The beam must have fallen and crushed his skull.
That's what it looks like.
Damn. I haven't been playing too much Skyrim because I'm like, ooh, dead body, get gold. Ooh.
Medical charts on the human anatomy.
Only with my face over them.
From the markings, he must have been one of their own. I wonder if he volunteered. They must have been trying to preserve the bodies.
He is freaking out right now.
Dead bodies, and plenty of them. Something dreadful has been going on down here. Seems like these cabinets
ketchup are and mustard.
Chemicals and medical
ketchup food. And mustard!
The two greatest chemicals of all.
Well, that's not odd in any way.
We're gonna go through this door.
This tunnel feels like it's gonna collapse at any moment.
We're gonna go this way.
Yeah.
I know what this is. Make things fuzzy.
He's like holding his breath.
That could be it.
Looks like his kidneys. They're moving around in all that liquid. This pipe must drain the waste from his intestines.
We're gonna slowly step away from that one.
Looks like his brain. I wonder what those wires are for. His beating heart. The contraption above seems to be controlling his breathing.
He says it so calmly.
Yeah, I know.
Looks like his stomach.
Jack Walters, I like you.
I've never seen equipment like this before. Good God, what the hell is all this?
This reminds me of the guy in,
Amnesia?
Yes.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking too.
Shit! Oh, fuck. Turn it off! Turn it off!
Not touching it again.
Well, I mean, to be fair, his brains and heart and stuff are out, so he was dead.
I think he blew his head off.
His misery.
Nope, it's there. Okay, never mind.
At least he's out of his misery.
I see a kryptonite crystal.
The crystal's still warm.
I just see a perfect emerald. You know? Need that poison damage.
Need that dexterity.
Nope. Poison.
Okay.
Ah! It's too hot to pick up.
What about now?
It's too hot to touch. I think it's being used as a power source for the machine.
Alright, definitely kryptonite.
It's a similar shape to the slot upstairs.
Good thinking.
This game's really dark. Wish we had a flashlight or something.
What the hell is that?
Good question, I can't see it.
Yeah, I don't know.
What are those crystals on Star Trek like? I forgot what they're called.
I'm the wrong person to ask.
So maybe it's one of those. I like kryptonite better. It's an Oblivion Gate. Peace out, Jack.
Game over, right?
It wouldn't let me move, so I'm gonna say no. Saving game. Saving game. Game over.
It's been more than 6 years since I entered that strange house in Boston. But to me, it was just 5 months ago. Amnesia.
Speaking of amnesia.
Probably brought on by acute mental stress. I remember investigating the far side of the library. There was screaming. According to the police report, they'd searched the house for hours, only to find me later collapsed on the floor. When my eyes opened and I spoke, my colleagues recoiled in fear. There was something unnatural in my voice and blank gaze. They committed me to an asylum, where I was diagnosed with severe schizophrenia.
That's where he met up with the Joker and Lex Luthor.
And
got the kryptonite.
Yep.
I was released from the asylum's care.
Makes sense.
I have learned little of my activities in the 6 years that followed. The accounts I've been able to piece together show much of my time was spent in travel and study. I maintain a fanatical infatuation with the occult, delving deep into volumes concerning witch cults and dark legends, often in languages unfamiliar to my own. When I reawakened 5 months ago, exactly 6 years after entering that house in Boston, no trace was left of what had been a secondary personality. I was myself again, or at least what I believed myself to be. Return to normal life has been a painful process. In recent days, my dreams have been plagued by cosmic landscapes, and I've become fearful of my own reflection. I'm beginning to remember things from that day, more than 6 years past, that I've told no one else.
Jack Walters.
Hello, Mr. Walters. My name's Arthur Anderson. I need your help finding a missing person.
I don't take that kind of job.
Did you get my package?
Hold on.
$1!
What exactly do you want?
There's quite a few ones there.
It's one of my store managers, you see. Brian's his name. Brian Burnham. Nice lad.
I like how the name starts with AA and BB, Brian Burnham.
Innsmouth? Eh, never heard of it.
It's a small fishing town on the coast, not far from Arkham. I'd like to see you in person before you leave.
Hold on there a minute. I didn't agree to take this what the hell? I'll be here all day anyway.
That's a trap. Oh, that's cool. It puts it right into the menu. Journal.